Welcome to another video in which we are going to learn about quotation and citation elements in HTML. So guys, we are going to see number of tags over here in this video to understand what are the different tags and their meaning. So the very first tag is the block quote tag. So as you can see, the HTML block quote element defines a section that is quoted from another source. So if you want to quote a particular section from another source in your HTML page, you can use the block quote tag over here. Now the browsers usually indent the block quote elements. So basically there is certain indentation on the left hand side while we are displaying the content inside the block quote tag. So guys, let us check this with the help of example now in the VS Code over here. So inside the body, we will first of all have the paragraph. So we have the P tag over here, and then we will have below content is within block quote. So guys, we have below content is within block quote. After this paragraph, we will have the block quote tag. So as you can see, we have the block quote tag that is being suggested by the VS Code over here. So we will use this, and then we will say this content is from another source. And then let us say we want to go to the next line, so we will have the BR tag over here. And then after this BR tag, what we will do is we will say this is another statement in block quote. So guys, basically we have two statements over here inside the block quote tags. So let me just save this file now and try reloading this page on the browser. So as you can see, we have the first paragraph that is below content is within block quote, and then you can see this content is within the block quote. And on the left hand side, we can see certain indentation over here. So guys, whenever you want to mention certain information from another source, you can mention it within the block quote so that it is understandable by the other developers as well that this particular content is from another source that is taken from the internet. And guys, that is the usage of this block quote tag over here. Now guys, let us move to another tag. So as you can see, we have the Q tag as well. So the HTML Q tag defines a short quotation. So basically, browsers normally insert quotation marks around the quotation. So whenever we have certain content in between the starting and the ending Q tag over here, so that content will be enclosed within the double quotes. So let us check this with the help of example now over here in the VS Code. So guys, we will have another paragraph. So we will define the P tag over here, and then we will say this text is within double quotes, and then we will say in this paragraph. So guys, this is a very simple paragraph that we have defined. Let me just save this file now and try running this code just to show you how it looks. So basically, this is another paragraph. It says this text is within double quotes in this paragraph, but we have not used the Q tag for now. So basically, we want to enclose this particular string, that is text is within double quotes in between the double quotes over here. So what we have to do is we need to enclose this text in between the starting and the ending Q tag. So let us come to the VS Code over here. So the starting Q tag is being defined, and the ending Q tag we need to provide after this quotes word. So guys, let me just save this file now. As you can see, we have enclosed only this substring in the entire paragraph in between the starting and the ending Q tags. So let me just come to the browser and reload this page. So as you can see, we are now getting the double quotes for this substring in this entire paragraph over here, and that is the main functionality of the Q tag in order to provide the double quotes in between the content where it is applied in our HTML source code. Now guys, let us move to another tag over here. So we have something called as ABBR tag. So the HTML ABBR tag defines an abbreviation or an acronym like HTML, CSS, etc. So guys, basically whenever you have certain abbreviation or the acronym to be defined, you can use the ABBR tag, and then you can provide the full form as well. So let me just come to the VS Code over here. We will write another paragraph. So we have the P tag, and then we will say this page is written in HTML. So basically the source code of this particular page is in HTML, and that is what we have written. This page is written in HTML. Now guys, what we want to do is, certain users won't be knowing what is the full form of this HTML. So we can enclose this HTML word in between the ABBR starting and the ending tag. So guys, over here we will mention ABBR tag over here, and then the ending tag will come after the HTML word. So guys, basically we have provided the ABBR tag. Now what happens when we reload this page? So let me just save this file now and reload this page on the browser. So it is displaying it as a normal paragraph over here, and we are getting this HTML word as well, but we are not getting the full form of this abbreviation. So what we can do is, we can come over here in the VS Code, and inside the ABBR tag we have the attribute called as title. So as you can see, it contains a text representing advisory information related to the element it belongs to. So basically we can provide the title in order to give the full form of this particular HTML word. So let me just provide this title, and we will say hypertext markup language, which is the full form of HTML. Because we have the full form, that is hypertext markup language. So when we provide the title inside this ABBR tag, let us see what happens now. Let me just save this file now and try reloading this page on the browser once again. So as you can see, it is now underlined with the dots over here, that is the HTML word is underlined. And when we get the cursor on this HTML word now, you can see that hypertext markup language, that is the full form that we have provided in the title attribute, is now being displayed to the user. And guys, this is the main functionality of this ABBR tag. It helps you to provide the full form of certain words, that is the abbreviations and the acronyms can be represented by this tag. So guys, you can use this tag based on your functionality and the requirements. Now let us move to another tag over here. We have something called as address tag as well. Now the HTML address tag defines the contact information for the author or the owner of a document or an article. So guys, let us try using this address tag now. So what we will do is, after this paragraph we will have the address tag over here. So we can use the address starting and the ending tag, and then guys, what we will do is, we will simply say YouTube channel name and then colon, and then on the next line we will say programming for beginners, which is the name of this YouTube channel, which you should definitely subscribe if you have not done so, in order to learn a lot about the web development and other programming languages. And then we will also have editor, which we use as VS Code. So guys, basically this is just an example that I am showing you. In reality, you will be using the exact address of certain person or the company based on your requirements that you want to display the information on the page. So this is just an example that we have taken in order to see how it looks on the web browser. So guys, let me just save this file now and try reloading this page once again on the browser. So as you can see, the address tag makes the content to be displayed with the italicized formatting on the text. Now guys, the entire content is being displayed on one single line. So what we can do is, we can provide the BR tag over here. So at the end of the lines, we can simply provide the BR tag over here. And now let us save this file now and try reloading this page once again. So as you can see, the entire content now is being displayed on the different lines over here inside the address tag, which is formatting the text and displaying it on the browser as the italicized text. Now guys, let us move to another tag over here. So we have something called a site tag as well. Now the HTML site tag defines the title of a creative work. So for example, a book, a poem, a song, a movie, a painting, etc. So basically the text in the site element usually renders in italic. So guys, again we have another tag, that is site tag, which will help the element to be displayed as italicized text. So guys, let us check this now with the help of example in the VS Code over here. So we will simply have another paragraph, and then we will say this video is created by programming for beginners YouTube channel. So we have programming for beginners YouTube channel. So guys, basically we have a very simple paragraph over here that we have defined. Let me just save this file now and try reloading this page on the browser. So as you can see, this is a very simple paragraph. Now guys, as we have just seen, the site tag, it helps us to define the title of a creative work. So it can be any author, a book, a poem. So basically what we are going to do is we are going to apply the site tag for this Programming for Beginners, because this is the YouTube channel that is helping us right now in order to learn HTML with the help of these videos. So guys, what I am going to do is we will have the site tag over here. So we have the site starting tag, and then I'll just cut this and paste it after the beginner's word over here. And then let me just save this file now and try reloading this page on the browser once again. So as you can see now, the Programming for Beginners, this text has been formatted with the italicized text, and this is how the content in between the site tag will be displayed whenever you are going to use it based on your requirements. So guys, these were certain quotation and citation elements in the HTML that you can use based on your requirements. The block quote helps us in order to quote some other information from another source. And then we also have the Q tag that will just enclose the string in between the double quotes over here. And then we have also used the ABBR tag, which will help us in order to display the abbreviations and the acronyms in HTML. We also have the address tag that can be used in order to display the contact information of an individual or a company or an organization as well. And then lastly, we have the site tag in order to display the name of the poem or any other creative work that has been done. So guys, comment in the comment section below whether you have learned something out of this video. Please make sure that you like this video so that it reaches to more people, and subscribe to the channel so that you get the notifications on upcoming videos as well. The next video that we are going to talk about is block versus inline elements in HTML. So stay tuned.